This is InfoLive TV headline news, April 12th. I'm Margot Dutkevich. The director of Gaza's only power plant says he'll have to shut it down in 2 to 3 days unless Israel resumes fuel shipments. Israel halted supplies after Gaza terrorists attacked a fuel depot on the Gaza-Israel border last week, killing 2 Israeli workers. Israeli defense officials indicated, however, that the cutoff will not last past the weekend. Accusing Israel of foot-dragging the peace negotiations, Nabil Abu Rudain, an aide to Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas, warned that if a peace agreement is missed, there will be anarchy in the region. Rudain has stressed that Palestinians are seeking a full agreement, a goal he said that was set out in the Annapolis conference, and will not be satisfied with understandings. An Israel Air Force airstrike Friday evening killed a Hamas operative in central Gaza only hours after 5 people were killed in an IDF ground raid near the central Gaza Borej refugee camp, where troops encountered heavy fire from Palestinian gunmen. Also Friday, Air Force missiles killed 2 Palestinians in southern Gaza. Since the terrorist infiltration at Nahal Oz, 14 Palestinians have been killed in IDF operations in Gaza. Israeli nuclear whistleblower Mordechai Vanunu has asked for asylum in Norway for a second time, Norwegian officials said Friday, but held out no hope that he would be accepted. Vanunu, whom Israeli authorities have barred from leaving Israel, sent his application directly to the Norwegian Prime Minister. His first application to Norway in 2004 was rejected. Israel has lodged a complaint with UN Secretary-General Ban Ki-moon over National Infrastructure Minister Benjamin Ben Eliezer's remarks this week that Israel would destroy Iran if it were attacked first. In a letter to Ban, Iran's UN envoy wrote, "The Israeli regime continues to make impudent threats against Iran. Ben Eliezer's remarks blatantly violate international law." That's all for InfoLive TV, Israel's only internet television network that broadcasts in 4 languages to the world from Jerusalem.